that we are going to look at, we are basically going to look at a simultaneous equation. Now, if you happen to go to the website, there are topics that I uploaded on the website, or that we uploaded on the website. You can go to the school website. You go where they are moving photos. Yeah. After the moving photos, there is a link below. Then you click in that link. Then they will take you directly to the notes. You choose a class. Don't choose Form 4. I know how much you want to be in Form 4, but choose Form 3. If you choose Form 3, they will give you the subjects. Then go to math. You get those notes. The simultaneous equations notes are there. Why are we repeating simultaneous equations? Yet this is the work that we are supposed to do in Form 2. And the reason as why we are repeating them is because they come in different ways. There are simultaneous equations that can come, and you fail to realize that indeed they are simultaneous equations that they're asking for. So how do you go about them? In today's lesson, we are going to basically look at the word problems that involve simultaneous equations. So the word problems that involve simultaneous equations, to start with, when you look at your screen, there is that number 25 that you can see on your screen. Number 25 on the screen, where they say that Tom traveled a distance of 52 kilometers in 6 hours. He traveled partly on foot at 4 kilometers per hour, that is the speed, and partly on a bicycle at 12 kilometers per hour. Then they're asking you to find the distance traveled on foot. In this case, they want you to specify the distance that he used, he walked. In other words, he traveled by foot, that is walking. He used the futushubish to move that distance. And then there is a distance where he used what? A bicycle. So all that distance, there is a distance where he used the bicycle, but he moved a total distance of 52 kilometers in 60 hours. This is a requirement that we're supposed to have. Now, here we're going to first of all, let me first give you time to write this number 25. We look at 25, Tom traveled a distance of, you write that question, Tom traveled a distance of 52 kilometers in 6 hours. He traveled partly on foot at 4 kilometers per hour, and partly on bicycle at 12 kilometers per hour. Remember, we are looking at simultaneous equations. What are simultaneous equations? These are equations that have more than one unknown. Now, those unknowns, you can solve them simultaneously. We have, if you look at what I'm writing on this board, when we are dealing with simultaneous equations, at this level, we have four methods of solving simultaneous equations. One of them is known as the substitution method. Secondly, if you fail to use that, you can able to use the elimination method. And what's wrong? Thirdly, you can use what we call the matrix method. And lastly, you can use the graphical method. All these methods are used in solving simultaneous what? Equations. And senior two, you looked at these two, and this one was as well. You looked at these three, in other words, in senior two. And in senior three, you've ably looked at the time that you spent here. We looked at the matrix method, all streams throughout. The matrix method, so you can ably use all the four methods. But when you are in an examination or when you're writing a paper, please don't use the four methods to prove to the examiner that you know much. No, it's not necessary. Use one method that is simple for you, any method. And don't use a method that you don't feel comfortable with, unless when they have told you that using elimination method, or they have told you that using matrix method, then they are useful. Specifically, use the method that is in question. But if they have not talked about it, then you can use any Now here I am. Okay. Now I'm going to look at the example that we are writing. When you look at your boy, they're telling us that Tom traveled a distance of 52 kilometers. So the distance that Tom was traveling is 52 kilometers in 6 hours. So here what we are going to do, we don't know the distance that he walked, neither do we know the distance that he used a bicycle. In other words, we don't know the distance that he cycled, right? And we don't know the distance he walked. So what are we going to do? What do you think we are going to do? We are going to? For the distance walked and that one that he used the bicycle, right? So how are we going to look for that distance? Tell me, how are we going to look for that distance? Okay, so we are going to first let, because we don't have busy distance, you're going to say let. We are looking at two distances. The distance that he did what? He walked. And that distance that where he did what? Let the walked. The walked what? Distance be x. And the distance moved on a bicycle be y. So I'm letting them to be x and y. Someone is asking me, Kayondo Elias is saying that what about the equating method? Yes, this method is also okay. It's more of the same like the substitution method. In other words, if you equate, it's like a substitution, my dear, okay? But it is also very okay. It's under the substitution bit of it. Thank you very much, Kayondo. Yes, if you have a question, you can go down into the comment section and you put it there. I will ably get it. Now, we are letting the distance that this person walked to be x, and the distance moved on a bicycle to be y. So, after letting this, we know that the total distance he walked, he first of all walked, that is x, plus the distance where he used the bicycle, that is y, will equal to the total distance. What is the total distance in this case? Tell me, what is the total distance? It is 52. So, this is our equation in one. I don't know whether it makes sense to you now. If they tell you that this person walked, he first walked a certain distance using a speed, they gave us the speed, right? And he used another speed to walk, okay? Remember, whenever you're talking about distance, now we look at what they call kinematics, yeah? And whenever you talk about distance, you cannot remove these two other words from the sentence where distance is. We have three things. That is distance. What is distance equaling to? Speed times z. So we have speed and time. So these ones should always be in the same sentence. You cannot talk about distance and you fail to talk about speed and time. The speed that a person will use and the time that he will take, he or she will take to move that distance. Now, since we know that time is equal to speed, distance is equal to speed times time. What do you think speed is? If I want to get speed here using subject of a formula, how am I going to get speed? So speed is going to be distance over time. I just divide by t on both sides, right? And if I'm looking for time, time will be distance over speed. Okay. So these are the things that we even looked at them in our primary. Remember that, if you remember very well, that distance is speed times time. Speed is distance over time. Time is distance over speed. So you're supposed to be very keen. Now, for the first equation, we say that if I add the distance that this person walked, and I add the distance where he used a bicycle, I will ably get the total distance he had to move of 52. Now, I'm going to continue. The question goes on to tell us, he traveled partly on foot at 4 kilometers per hour. And what? And partly on a bicycle at
12 kilometers per hour. Remember, on foot, he was using a speed of 4 kilometers per hour. So here, I think we can get time, right? But the total time he used to move that journey was how long? What is the time? 52 kilometers in it. He used 6 hours. I don't know whether I can see that. So this person used 6 hours. But there is a time he used it to move by foot, and there is a time he used to move by a bicycle, right?
Yes.
So you have to add that time and you come up with it, 6 hours. Altogether. If I add the time this person used while walking, and I add it to the time that this person also used while cycling, altogether, someone is saying bicycling. While cycling. So we'll come up with a 6 hours, a total of six what? Hours. Right? So here we are. The time when he was, remember the distance he used in walking, the distance walked was X, right? So the time we'll spend while walking will equal to distance over speed. Do you agree with me? So the time he walked was X over what is the speed he used was using for walking? He traveled partly on foot at E. So X over 4 plus, you get me now. Then he also used bicycle. And what was the speed? Bicycle is Y over 2 kilometers per hour, eh? 12 kilometers. So it is over 12. It will give us 6 hours altogether. So if you get the time he used a bicycle, the time he walked, and when the time where he used a bicycle, you'll come up with the 60 hours. You see how we have two equations? Now this is equation E. Two. You can ably solve those equations simultaneously. Do you agree with me? Can you solve this one simultaneously using any method? Altogether. Now, to make this one, at least this one is a little bit complex, okay? But you can try to make it easier. You remember we looked at algebraic fractions, right? So what am I going to do to remove these denominators? I'm going to find the LCM using the second equation, okay? I want to make the second equation look like this one without these fractions altogether.
Yes.
So I'm going to find LCM of 4 and 12. The LCM of 4 and 12. The LCM of 4 and 12 is what? It is 12. You agree with me? The LCM of 4 and 12, if it is so hard for you, come here. Please come here. 12. And 4, we are looking for the LCM. Use another method. By 2. By 2. And here?
6.
By 2. 3. Right? By 2. You see that? Then the LCM is going to be 2 times 2. By 3. This is 3. Yeah? But times 3. Right? Which is 4 times E. And this is E. 12. Do you agree with me now? So the LCM of 4 and 12, if it is so hard for you, please go for this. Is it 12? Altogether. Now, after realizing that LCM is 12, what am I going to do with the LCM? I'm going to multiply it on each term. I multiply it everywhere in that equation, okay? So it is 12. Remember, if you have a question, please write it in the comment section, and I will read it here, and I will answer you very well. Over 12. It's over 12. Sorry for that. Over 12 is equal to 12 times 6. If you're observant enough, you can see that I've multiplied 12 everywhere. Okay? So this 12 goes with that. Okay? And then by 4?
1.
By 4? 3. So it is 3 times x, which will give me plus c. This is it. 12, 1, not so, because this is 1 and this is 1, okay?
Yes.
So 1 times y is equal to 12 times 6. What is the answer? Tell me. 12 times 6, use your calculator. Is it 72? Okay. So this is, don't tell me that this is equation 3. Which equation is this? It is still equation 2, but we've just modified it altogether.
Yes.
So you can solve this and this. Okay? Bahati is saying that re-explain some of us have just come. Yes, Bahati. I think to be on the safer side, this video, when we finish here, this video goes to the video library. Because remember, we have limited time here. If I choose to explain from the start, yeah, then we'll have to consume a lot of time. Yes, we have only 1 hour here. So I think it would be better after this video, you go back and watch the video from the start. Because it's going to go to the video library. Even if you spend like 2 days, you can as well go back and see. You can see it, but I request that you see it here immediately after this. So, but to explain a little bit, we are looking at simultaneous equations, okay? But you're looking at those simultaneous equations that involve word problems. Now, if you happen to meet some words, to start with, let me put my screen back. There is a question we are looking at here. If you can look at your screen, they are saying that Tom, let me put it back on your screen. Yes, they are saying that Tom traveled a distance. That one you see, number 25. Tom traveled a distance of 52 kilometers in 6 hours. They continue to tell you that he traveled partly on foot at 4 kilometers per hour and partly on a bicycle. So the 52 kilometers was traveled in, like he traveled them in a series. Like he first of all traveled by foot. He moved, he was walking for the first distance. And then the last distance, he was using a bicycle, he was cycling. Now, here, we don't know the distance that he walked. So what we do, we have to let, if you can see here, the first thing that I did was to let. I let the walked distance be X, and the distance moved on a bicycle be Y. So if you add the distance that he walked and that one that he used the bicycle, you get the 52 kilometers that he had to move. Because these are kilometers. There's no need of adding the symbols there. Rather, the units there, okay? Then, they continue, in that very question, they gave us the time that he used for the whole distance. The whole distance of 52 kilometers, which is 6 hours. But they went on to give us speed for each thing that he was doing. When he was walking, he was using a speed of 4 kilometers per hour. So a speed of 4 kilometers per hour, how do you get that? It's time. You get distance over speed, because we say distance, speed, and time. You cannot talk about one and you fail to talk about the other two. They are all supposed to be in the same sentence. So they always, it is always distance. You cannot know the distance if you don't look at the speed and the time that a person is using. Or there is no way you can come up with the time, no, without realizing the distance and the speed. So here we say that time is equal to distance over speed. How did we come up with that? Because from distance is equal to speed times time, the same time, if I want to get time, time will equal to distance over speed. So it is this equation here that we are using, we are applying here. How do we apply it? We say the walking distance, we don't know the time, but the time is spent while walking, as the time is spent while cycling. If I add the two, I'll come up with the 6 hours that he used to move that journey. That is it. Okay? Then these are two simultaneous equations. You solve them. The other thing that we are doing was to find the LCM of 4 and 12. Of course, we want to make this one look like this without these denominators. You multiply this 12. The LCM is 12 of this and this. Then you multiply it on each term here. We are only dealing with this because we want to make this look like this. So we have two equations which we can solve. I think I can pick up from there. Now, the two equations are x plus y is equal to 52 and vx plus y is equal to 72. Now, from here, you can use any method of your choice, the one that is simpler for you. One, someone will tell me to use matrix method. Another person will choose to use elimination because the question is not strict that you should use this. Now, I personally am going to use the substitution method. And then the substitution method,
I will say this is equation one and this is equation two as they were initially. So here, let me divide my board. Here, I'm going to write here. So here, I'm going to first make from equation one, from equation one, I'm going to say, from one, I'm going to make x the subject, x from one, make x the subject. From one, I'm making x the subject. So one is x plus y is equal to 52. How am I going to make x the subject? Can you tell me how am I going to make x the subject here? It's y is going to go the other side, right? So it's going to become x is equal to 52 minus y. You call this one equation ash. Okay? Another person can call it equation 3, another person can call it equation star, another person can call it equation anything that you want, name them. Okay? This is equation ash. Now, after identifying that x is this, then you substitute it, not in the first equation this time around, my dear, no, but you substitute it in the second equation. We use the first equation to make x the subject. Another person can choose to use the second equation to make x the subject, but if you use this to make x the subject, then you substitute the what you've got in the first one. But since we used the first one to make x the subject, we substitute what we got in the second equation. So I'm going to say the second step, substituting ash into equation what? Into equation two. I'm substituting this ash that I've got here. I'm putting it in equation two. Where is the equation two? It is this one. Where you have x here. Can you see where you have x? Where you have this x, let me put here is a blue map. Where you have this x here, you are going to put there the whole of this. Cos x is equivalent to the whole of this. Are we together? Now, I'm going to say 3 into 52 minus y plus y is equal to 72. Now you see how we've eliminated, we have removed x. You see x anywhere now. So we don't have any x anywhere in our new equation. So we can deal with y, okay? So it's going to become 52 times 3. Place your calculator so fast. 52 times 3. What do we have there? 156. Minus this 3, remember this 3 multiplies the whole bracket, not so?
Yes.
And this is 3, y plus y is equal to 72. Now from here, what am I going to do? Guide me. So I'm going to make this, I'm going to get this and I put it the other side, not so?
Yes.
All right, I'm going to limit to remove this and I take the other side. Oh, you want me, because this one is alone, I bring it this side and I remain with these y's on this side, okay?
Yes.
So it becomes negative 3y plus y is equal to 72. When this one crosses the equal sign, it is a positive. Where is it going to become?
Negative.
Minus 156. So negative 3y plus y, what do you think we get? We get negative 2y. Is equal to, it's like you have negative 3 plus 1, the answer will be negative 2. Not so, because someone is having, someone is having a date of negative 3, a date of 3 rather, a date of 3, and he has got 1. So you play that date using 1, and you remain with a date of what? 2. That's what we have here. So, 72 minus 156, what is the answer? Negative 84. So what am I going to do here? By negative 2, right?
Yes.
If I divide by negative 2, y is going to be, the negatives will cancel. Also, what is y going to be? 42. These are what? This is the distance. Also, Then we look for x from, if you want to get x in a simple way, just look at the equation which we use to substitute. The third equation, or the equation h, okay? So from equation h, you say from h, x is equal to 52 minus what is y? So x is what? Is 10. X is 10, right?
Yes.
Therefore, you come here and say, therefore, we are looking at Tom. Tom, what are they asking for?
The distance you traveled.
The distance you traveled on foot. That is what? Is that the x? Not so. Yes. Tom traveled. Traveled on foot a distance of what?
10 kilometers.
You traveled on foot, that is x, a distance of 10 kilometers. That is it. So that is the answer that they wanted us to get. Now, I can leave you time to write this that you see on here. I started with this. I started by letting, and then I worked out this. Then I came here, and finally concluded with this. If you've been observant enough, this is the equation that we're going to look at. Now, I want you to, first of all, write down this. You write down this. I don't want to be so fast. I want you to write down this. Then after, I'm going to give you a number to try out. So you need to be fast. You're going to try out and send me the answer in the comment section. Those answers, or you send me the solutions. You're going to send me the solutions in the comment section, and I will be reading them out. You send me the solutions. If you fail to send them on the comment section, just take a photo of what you've calculated and send it on my WhatsApp number. For those of you who are coming in today, my WhatsApp number is 0786-0196-019-648. You can send it to me on my WhatsApp number, and I will be sharing with others here. I want you to do it now after writing down this. So I want you to write down this. Then eventually you come up with a, then eventually we do the number that I'm going to give you. Okay, to see whether you've really understood what I was talking about. So you write down that as we are coming. Thank you. Okay, now let us look at the question. That is question 26 on your screen. I think we've finished writing. Now we are doing question 26. All of us, we are doing question 26. You give it a try. That's 26. We are doing 26, and after you send me the solutions on then if time catches us, please, there is notes on the, there is questions about this simultaneous question word problem that are very interesting. So if we run out of time, I request that you go and download those questions on the school website, and you do all of those questions, or you can get them even from here. You can get them from here. You can download them from this very platform, and you get those questions. Then you try all of them out. But right now, we are trying out 26. Nanono Kavuma is asking that, why is it that For the first equation, you equated to distance of 52 kilometers. And the second equation, you equated to a time of 60 hours. Yes, no. Thank you for that. Now, sorry, but let me take you back here. And I show you why I had to do that. In the first place, we said that the distance, the question was saying that Tom traveled a distance of 52 kilometers. But they told us that he traveled partly on foot and partly on a bicycle. So if you traveled partly on foot, we say that let the distance, even if you traveled partly by foot, was just traveling. That is the distance. So that let the walked distance be X. And the distance moved on a bicycle be Y. So we are just letting the distance, we are looking at distance now. We are looking at it in a perspective of the distance. So X, it is the distance that is walked. And Y is also distance that is what? Cycled using a bicycle. So the total distance will always be 52. Here we are looking at it in a perspective of distance. That's why we are equating 52. 52, we have it in the question. Then number two, they continue to tell us that the question was saying that he traveled partly on foot at 4 kilometers per hour. So the 4 kilometers per hour, my dear, it is just the speed. If you've been observant, I said that if you talk about distance, you cannot avoid or you cannot do away with the time and the speed. These three things will always be in the same sentence. That's what I was saying. They will always be in the same sentence. So if you talk about distance, time, and speed, okay? Distance, time, and speed. Here they talk about he walked for 4 kilometers at 4 kilometers per hour. That is speed at 4 kilometers per hour. So to get the speed, and they remember in the first place they were telling you that he moved 52 kilometers in 60 hours. So they gave you the total time he used to move the 52 kilometers. Okay? So the total time, how will I come up with the total time? I will say the time that he walked, that is distance over speed. I have the distance that he walked. We let it to be X. Okay? Yes. So it is X over the speed that is 4 kilometers per hour. Okay? Then plus the time that he spent while cycling, which is Y over 12. It will give us the total time, that is 6. That's why here we have 6. But what we are interested in is having X and Y in the two equations. We have them.
and then we learn to deal with them. Here, just remove the denominators by finding the LCM, you multiply, you come up with this equation. This is still equation 2, but you just modified it so that it looks like equation 1 and you store of them simultaneously as we did there. Kavuma, you should tell me whether we are together now. Tell me whether we are together now. Let us get back to the question that you're trying out. I want you to send me your results or your what you get on the... Send them to me. That is 26. You see 26 there? We are trying out 26. We are trying out 26. You're going to try out 26? I don't know whether Kavuma has put there in the comment section. Nanono is saying that, is it wrong if I first find the distance for the second equation since I have been given the speed and the time? Now, even if you try to find, you've been given the speed and time, okay? If you've been, no, you've not been given speed and time for the second distance, but for the total journey, you're given the distance and time. Maybe if you want to find the speed, but remember these two people, rather, this one person is using two things. First of all, he walked. And eventually, he cycled using a bicycle. Okay? So, you're supposed to know, and you're supposed to be specific on the time is spent while cycling. And that time is spent while walking. So, you're supposed to be specific on that. Now, after realizing that if you get the total time that is walked and the time that is, if you get the time that is walked plus that time that is cycled, you'll come up with the total time of the journey, which is 6 hours. That's why we had to add them. So we are doing 26. I'm waiting for your solutions on my WhatsApp number or here. You can send it here on the school website. You can take a photo or you can send your answer there. Thank you. Okay, you people, I'm waiting for the solution, but I'm not receiving any. I'm telling you, God, I'm waiting for your solution. It's nowhere to be seen. What do you have there? Remember, the other one was in kilometers per hour, but this one is in meters per second. So you're supposed to be specific. You're supposed to be careful with the units, but almost the same thing. Bashira is just asking that are the answers. Bashira Namaganda. Is it Namaganda? Namaganda. Yeah, I think it is Namaganda. He's asking that are the answers 3 and 150. 3 and 150. The answers that he has. Bashira. Yes, any other person? Kayondo is also having 150 and 350. Yes, Kayondo, yes. I've seen that. Okay. So these two people, since time is not our best ally, please allow me to relocate. Now, allow me to relocate to question number 28. Now, you look at question number 28. We are going to continue with a discussion on our WhatsApp platform, please. Time is not our best ally. Yes, I've got 350 and 150. That is a need that we have. Someone, that is what Elias and Namaganda have given us. Even others, you can keep on trying. But let's first look at this, because time is not our best ally. Let's first look at this. 28, help me copy that question 28. Write it down, question 28. You see, it is also calling for simultaneous equations, but you see a way it is tricked. That's why we needed to look at it. Sesanga is confused. Sesanga Rayani, what is bringing the confusion, Sesanga? Mugera Arafat is also having 150 meters and 350 meters, meaning 150 and 350 is most likely to be the correct solution for this problem. Sesanga, who is saying that he's confused? Please, what is bringing the confusion, Sesanga? Bring your question and we see how we can help you out. Don't be confused. Yes, we have, I think people are bringing solutions here. Okay.
Yes, Kasirie Ndagire is also having 350 and 150. Yes, Kasirie. Thank you for those of you who have given me the solutions. Kayondo, Badru, Namaganda, Mugera Arafat, Kasirie Ndagire. At least you people have. Bushira Namaganda, yes. But Sesanga, who is confused, you've refused to raise your root cause of the confusion. And others, please, can you share your solutions as we continue? Now, let's look at 28. You take your... Let's take our mind to 28. You see all these questions, they are looking... All these problems are looking for solutions. Now, after this lesson, don't you think that it is the end? You can get on board, because we take a lot of time to take these things, you people. Please don't just keep them there. Go to the website, get them, try them out. All of them. They are around 32 questions or 32 problems. So you need to do with them. You need to do. Aita Emmanuel. Yes, Aita Emmanuel is having also 350 and 150. Yes, Aita. That is very correct, also. Yes, and that is very true. Mm-hmm. Now I'm looking for other solutions. Okay, let's continue. Let's write down that question 28, where we have a triangle. Okay, so here we are now when you look at this question, find the values of x and y in a given equilateral triangle below. Find the value, find the values of x and y. X and y. We are finding the values of this. When they talk about, if we're looking at triangles, we majorly have three types of triangles. We have what they call an isosceles triangle. We have an equilateral, which is like this one. In other words, all the sides are equal. All the three sides are equal. And we have what they call an right angle D. Right angle D triangle. If you want to look at these two, an isosceles triangle, it is this type of triangle that has two sides equal and two angles are also equal. If this is X, this is also X. The base angles are also equal for an isosceles triangle. Then an equilateral triangle, this is the triangle with all sides equal. Then when I happen to talk about an right angled triangle, which is this triangle that you've seen several times, we call it a right angled triangle because it has a right angle somewhere, which is 90 degrees. So there are majorly three types of triangles that we look at this level. So now, we can also have a scalene triangle or a triangle that has sides that are not equal. By the way, you can also have a scalene triangle that have different sides when sides are not equal at all. Each side has its own dimension, okay? So there are basically, those are the types of triangles that we can look at. But in this case, we have
an equilateral triangle. A triangle with all the sides being equal. If they tell you that all sides are equal, what do you do here? You know that this one is equaling to this. So I can just equate. I say 2x is equaling to 3y plus 8. Can I get an equation out of that? How am I going to get it? By moving this 3y to this side, right? So it's going to become 2x minus 3y is equaling to 8. That is equation 1. You see? Then you look, you can find other sides and equate them. What should we equate? Equate this and this, or equate this and that? Equate what?
2x
and x. 2x and x plus
2y.
So we equate 2x. It is equaling to. It is equaling to x plus 2y. Now here we are. What am I going to do to come up with a simultaneous equation in this format? All of these ones are going to come this side, not so? And when they come this side, what do we remain with on this side? Remain with a zero, right? So it is 2x minus x minus 2y is giving us what?
Zero.
Hope we are together. So this is x minus 2y giving us what?
Zero.
Are we together? Now this is equation 2. Another person may have used this and this, but still you come up with the two equations, okay? Now after getting the two equations, I think I can solve them simultaneously. So the two equations are 2x minus 3y is equaling to 8, and then x minus 2y is equaling to 0. Now look at these two equations. I'm going to use elimination method to deal with them, okay? This time, remember the first equation, the first simultaneous equation, I used substitution. Now let me change that. I use the elimination, okay? If I'm to use the elimination, I have to first identify the equations. This one is having a coefficient of 2, and this one is having a coefficient of 1. I'm trying to eliminate x. So I'm going to create a bracket, okay? The one that is here, I multiply it on this equation, but it multiplies the whole. Not so?
Yes.
And these two, I multiply it down here. So when they multiply, it's going to be 2x minus 3y, giving me what?
8.
And then this is going to be
2x
minus 4y. 0. Okay? Then after, if the signs are the same, if this is positive and this is positive, what you're eliminating, yeah? Then you subtract. But if one of them is positive and the other one is negative, you do what? You add. Okay? Because the numbers will always be the same, but the signs can be changing. Okay? But if the signs are the same, positive, positive, you subtract altogether. Even if they are negative, negative, you subtract. Are you getting me? But if one of them is positive and the other one is negative, you do what?
You add.
So here I'm going to subtract. 2x minus 2x, 0. Then negative 3y minus 4y. It's like you have negative 3y minus negative 4y. This one is going to become negative 3y plus 4y. Negative 3 plus 4, what is the answer? It is 1y, which is y. Can you see that you have a debt of negative 3 and you have 4. You have a debt of 3 and you have 4. So you play that debt using the 3 and you win with only what? 1. So negative 3 minus this, it is 1, which it is 1y, which is positive. No, so?
Yes.
So here I add plus y, because the y is positive, is equal to 8 minus 0. So you eventually say that y is equal to what? What is y now? Tell me, what is y?
It's equal to 8.
Y is equal to 8. You see that, yeah?
Yes.
Then again, I can bring the equations again and I eliminate what? Eliminate y to get x. So it is 2x minus 3y is equal to
8.
Then the other equation is it? X minus 2y is equal to what? to 0. So Isota is asking that, so even if I use a calculator and state the answer, is it okay? Please, Isota, I know that we know how to use a calculator, my dear, but if they tell you to solve or to, they have not told you to state altogether, but they have told you to calculate or solve altogether. Now, there should be a working that you are following altogether. Now, an examiner may think that you've just copied the answers and you just put them on the paper. So please don't use a calculator. At least use a method, and you follow steps. You can use any method. Other people can come up with. There are very many ways of killing the rat, as I normally tell you. Others, they give them books to read. Others, they do what? You know these books that they use to catch rats. Uh-huh. So there are very many things that we use. So even these workings that we have here, there are very many solutions. You cannot just give in your answer and state it. It will be wrong, or they won't mark it. The answers may be correct, but they won't mark them, because they may even think that it is copying. You've got them from maybe a neighbor, you've just picked and got the solutions and you write them there. So always have a streamlined working that you fold altogether. Now here we are. So here I want to eliminate BC. I want to eliminate Y. So I'm going to create brackets for these two. The coefficients of Y, now this is 2. I am going to take it is negative 2. I can take a negative 2 or I can take 2. Altogether.
Yes.
Now what should we take? That's why I was telling you that if you're confused with the signs, altogether. If you're confused with the signs, please, if the signs are the same here, you subtract. If they are different, you add what you are eliminating. Now here we are. Should I take negative 2 here and I bring negative 3 here, or I take 2 and 3? Let me take them with their signs, okay?
Yes.
So I take a negative 2 here. And here I take a negative 3. So negative 2 with the 2, what do we get? Negative 4x. Negative 2 times negative 3. Positive 6y. Are we there?
Yes.
Then this is equaling to, tell me, negative 2 times 8?
Negative
6. You see that, yeah?
Yes.
Then negative 3 times x? 3x. Negative 3 times negative 2, what? You see the signs are the same, yeah?
Yes.
So what are you going to do there? This times this, we get a 0. Not so?
Yes.
What are we eliminating? This time around, we are not eliminating the x, but we are eliminating the y's altogether.
Yes.
What are we going to do? We are going to, the signs are the same. What are we going to do?
Subtract.
I'm going to subtract these ones. Negative 4x minus negative 3x. Negative 4x minus negative 3x. They will change the signs also.
Yes.
And remain with negative 4x plus 3x, which is equal to negative x. You see that here? Then this is negative x. Then 6y minus, this minus here will be subtracted. Mm-hmm. 6y minus 6y. The answer is plus z.
Zero.
Negative 16 minus 0. The answer will be negative
16.
You see that?
Yes.
Then we are going to have negative x is equal to negative
16.
And eventually our x is going to be
16.
Therefore, x is equal to 16 and y is equal to what?
8.
We conclude like that. So that is the solution in that case that we have. So you're supposed to be very keen here, and you come up with a streamlined solution. Okay, now, I want to do only one question, and I leave you with the rest. I don't know whether I should do this one. Hello. Yes, sorry, we had some interactions. We had some power challenges. Power had gone off, but
I think we are now okay. You know, it was just unforeseen things that come. But right now we are back. We are back. So I think right now we can go on. So I'm trying to show you on the two exercises that we have. Now I'm going to do this one of a set. Those of you who... I'm going to do this one of a set. There is even work that I gave you for sets. You look at your screen. It's it's question 32. You can see it very well. It's question 32 on the page. You look at it on your screen, question 32. There we are. That 32 there. So we are going to try out that 32, and then I give you the rest of the work. Where you meet a challenge, you know where you can go to, or you refer to the group, and you get assistance from there. There are very many people there who can assist you, but if all that fails, then you contact me. People should learn doing these things and practice, because mathematics is all about practice. The more you practice is the more you learn. You cannot learn it by just reading it as you're reading newspapers. You have just practice, and the more you practice is the more you learn the math bit of it. I'm trying to summarize what we have here. P union Q is equal to 16. Complement is equal to 7. 2 complement. Okay, here we are. Now I think right now you can see what I've summarized on the board. I've tried to summarize the question. Now they have given us that in a Venn diagram below, sets P and Q are such that the number of P union Q is 16. Now, if they tell us the number of P union Q, these are the things that they are talking about, all the things that are involved here. Without this one, all the things that are involved here. P union Q, it is this part here. It is the P union Q. So you're supposed to be very keen. If they wanted to mean the whole set, they would have used the number of summation. It means everything in the box altogether. Yes. So, but right now, if they say a P union Q, they're talking about the two things, the people who are in these two circles and even in the middle. So the people who are here, without these ones who are outside. So they tell us that number of P complement is 7. Okay. Now, if they say that number of P, the complement bit of it in sets, it is refusing altogether. If they say that P complement, it means that P not inclusive altogether. If they say P complement, it means you're going to remove P and you remain with what you're supposed to remain with. If they say P complement, you remove the P like this. And what you remain with it is this and that. I've removed the P. That is the P complement. That's what it means, that this plus this is 7. Altogether.
Yes.
If it is P complement, it means the rest without P are equal to 7. So can we interpret that? I'm going to say P complement is equal to 7. Remove the whole of P.
we are going to remain with the B plus C is equal to 7. And see that, yeah?
Yes.
Then I proceed. Number of two complement. Number of two complement is equal to what? To 6. To 6. So I also remove what?
Q.
If you remove Q, remember, if you remove Q, you don't remove this one here altogether.
Yes.
But if you remove the Q, so what do you remain with here? A plus C is equal to what? To 6. So it is A plus C that is giving us what?
6.
You can see that, yeah? Then they continue to tell us that the whole of these ones here are equal to 16.
16.
Mm-hmm. So what am I going to do? A plus C plus B plus 7. This and this. They are what gives these ones, these three, they give us what, the 16, yeah? And this C is outside, it's not part of P union Q. Are you getting me? So this plus this, it will give us 16.
16.
Okay. You can organize this and it becomes A plus B. So this is equation 1, this is equation 2, and we are organizing equation 3, right? A plus B is equal to 16 minus what?
7.
So A plus B is equal to what? What? 9, yeah? Mm-hmm. So this is equation 3. You can organize these equations together to see whether you can do this. You can. A plus B is equal to 9. Another equation is B plus C is equal to 6. Then finally, B plus C is equal to 7.
Thank you.
To 7. 7. And lastly, this one here. A plus C is equal to what?
6.
So we have three equations. You can look at them, okay? Now ask yourself, do we have two equations which we can use to solve and get there and in own C? Ask yourself, are they there? If you look at this, this one has A and B. Do you have any other equation with A and B? This one is having A, but it is having C. This one is having B and C. This one is not having B and C. So if you look very well, you don't have any two equations that are similar. You only have the same unknown. So what do you do? If you're observant enough, this is A and B. Eh? But there is no any other equation that has A and B. You see that?
Yes.
This one has A and C. Then if you look at B, this is B and A. But this is B and C. It is not B and A. I don't know whether it is confusing. Is it confusing? These three equations, all of them, okay? They have unknown. They have two unknowns, okay?
Yes.
But remember, for simultaneous equation, you must look for two equations with the same unknowns.
Mm-hmm.
Altogether.
Mm-hmm.
Remember the other equation, xy. Well, that's why we are dealing with them. Because each of them had xy, and the other had xy. But here, this one is having ab, and this one is having bc. Okay? It does not have ab. We don't have ab anywhere. Are you getting me now?
Yes.
This is BC. We don't have any other BC, but the other B is with the A. Are you getting me?
Yes.
This is AC. We don't have any other AC anywhere, A and C. So that's why I'm telling you that these ones will be a little bit harder to deal with them. So what do you think we are going to do? What do you think we are going to do? Share with me. Can someone tell me through the comment section what we are going to do? I want to read and see whether you people have some knowledge about sets. What do you think we are going to do? I hate being the... you people here, what are you going to do here? You have the equations that have unknowns which are not the same. After you realize, yeah, that if I do BC, this is AB. This is... Yeah? What am I going to do about these ones? Okay? There are three equations, 1, 2, 3. Eh?
Yes.
But the three equations, all of them have unknowns, different unknowns. In other words, they don't have the same unknowns. So I'm looking for the solutions from you people. Now, let me give you an idea. Now, if you have two equations, if you have three equations, let me remove them and I start. Okay, let me write them here. B plus C is equaling to 7. That is equation 1. I'm wasting my whiteboard here. Let me leave this space. Let me write them again here. B plus C is equaling to 7. This is 1. Then the second equation is what? A plus C
is equal to 6.
This is 2. And then lastly,
A plus B
is equal to 9. This is 3. Okay? So if you realize that you have these three equations, yeah? And all of them have different unknowns. Then you step from one, you make one of them the sum. If you happen to meet this, the only method that can solve this equation is substitution. Are you getting me? So you say from one. Now I'm solving. Don't say from one. Here we are. So you say from equation one. So from equation, what do you have? You have B plus C is equal to 7. What are we going to make as the subject? What should we make as the subject?
B,
eh? So B is equal to 7
minus
C. We call this one equation R. Are you getting me? Another person can call it equation 3, another 4, another person, name them, okay? Equation star. But me, I enjoy using R and star, eh? You can call them anything. So this is equation R. Then B is equal to 7 minus C is equation R. Then you look for this, you look at these three equations and see whether B is. That's where you're going to substitute it. Everything. In which equation do we have B? Leaving alone this one that we've used. Do you have any other equation where you have B? Which equation? The third one, yeah? So you say substituting R into equation what? You see that, yeah? Why are we substituting? Because B, you cannot substitute it here because here you don't have B. But we need to substitute it where B is, okay? So that where you have B, you put there 7 minus C. So if you get A plus C, what is B? B is 7 minus C. We are substituting it here. This is the equation. Remember, the equation is E. A plus B is equal to 9. How together? So where I have B is where I'm putting 7 minus C. Hope we are together there. Let me continue now. So 7 minus C is equal to what? 9. So I've substituted where I have this one. Here. In equation 3. I mean, here, I've put there this. Can you see that? So in this place, plus B, it is plus 7 minus C, is equal to 9. This is the equation. We proceed, okay? Now, if I'm to proceed, I'm going to arrange this equation. It's going to become A minus C is equal to 9 minus 7. You know where the 7 has gone? This is negative, yeah, but this one is coming this side. Okay. So now it is A minus C giving us what? Giving us 2. This is equation 4. Okay. You name it as equation 4. When you look at equation 4, it has an equation that you can solve it with. You can solve it with this equation. They have the same unknowns. You see that? So, here in math, whenever you have three unknowns, three equations with each of them having different unknowns, you get one equation, you make one term the subject, you substitute it in the other, then the equation that you've left behind will be the same with the other one. You can solve them simultaneously. All together. In mathematics, we just learn steps. You don't supposed to cram these things that are, this is A, this, you just learn steps that have met these, there are three equations. They don't have any similar unknowns. They don't have two similar unknowns. What do I do? Then make one of them the subject in the first equation. Substitute it in the equation where it is what you've made the subject. Then the other equation that you left with will be the same as this equation that you've got here. Okay? So this is equation 4. You substitute it with the equation. You solve it with the equation 2. So it's a solving equation 2 with the equation what? With the equation 4. So you are going to solve equation 2 with equation 4. What is equation 2? Tell me. A plus C. And the other one? You see that? So you can solve this one simultaneously. I think every one of us can solve this one. You can solve them. So I think you can pick it up from there and do the needful. I'm not going to solve these ones. I'm going to leave them to you to finish them after realizing. Then after getting A and C, you can substitute here and you get B. Not so?
Yes.
So you can substitute here after having C and you get B. Then it would be very simple for us. You can use any method, matrix, elimination, substitution, but don't use graphical in section A. It is very long, yeah? In other words, it will take you a lot of time and it will have only 4 marks if it is in section A. Even here, if you're solving and you want to use a graph, it will be a long procedure that you're going to take. So I request that you do the remaining solutions that we have here. If there is any question, please forward it here, and I will attend to you. Send your questions if you have them. I'm ready to attend to your questions. And then you are going to do all of these exercises. All of these numbers here are calling for simultaneous equations. All of these ones that you see here. So please try out. They have different tricks. For me, I've done all like 4 of them. So you can try out. Because we take time to take these things. There are 32. For me, I have a belief that a person cannot do these 32 and you remain the same. 32 questions. You have the whole week to do them. If you meet any challenge, please tap on me and I help you out. But if you have any question, please write it in the comment section and I attend to it. Otherwise, I have got to go. So, that's what we have. Let me know what people are writing. Giving you time to write this, write that.